You have your coffee?
Welcome to God Doesn't... God.
Got this.
Welcome. Oh, I did it right. Okay, you're here. Welcome to God Doesn't Say That.
Where we talk about the lies we believe
or are believing
and replace them with God's truth.
Yes, but before we get started, go ahead and like this video, subscribe below so that you can... Did I do that right?
You did. I'm just laughing because
it says they've had to put point below because I struggle with directions and what day it is and a lot of things.
But you did it right.
But I'm not going to believe a lie about that because we really want you to follow along each week with us because we love having you.
Yes.
And like our house is so chaotic. There's either a vacuum going, a toilet flushing, a dog barking. We've had a like
it's a little
really,
bit like a war zone.
It is so funny, which means, you know what happens? I think that like sometimes like there's a thing called like spiritual opposition, like we're something good. Like I think there's a message for you in this and there's like all these things trying to prevent it. But like there is a message here for you today. Yes. And I'm excited. So Rebecca.
Yes. So God's word tells us that we can take every thought captive and make it obey Christ, which is a really, really cool like truth. However, it seems kind of complicated. And like, what does that even mean, Katie?
Well, I think it says like what happens is when we can see a lie coming our way, we can now identify it and say, that's a lie. God doesn't say that. Now what's the truth? And we do this all the time in our house because it really started even in your family. Is like you can really, like we believe these lies and they prevent us from like who the Father really is. Like we talked a lot about how the Father's arms are open wide. Like God has love and joy for us, but so often we don't go to the heart of the Father and we believe a lie that we have to be out there on our own.
Right, yeah. And so making like something obey Christ, exactly what Katie's saying. It's like, it's basically, it's just replacing a lie.
Yeah, it's called renewing your mind.
With truth.
Yeah.
So Katie, is there been a lie that you have struggled with or are struggling with that our viewers might be interested to know?
Well, this is something that really truly is going on right now. It's that I'm alone.
And that's a lie.
Yeah.
God doesn't say that. What's the truth?
The lie is that He is with me and will never leave my side. And more than that too, is like God is never, He is always with me. And He also gives me other people. I believe a lie, especially after this season of such isolation that like I'm gonna be like separated from people forever. And I can't, like I can't handle that.
Me neither. Yeah, we had like the ice storm a couple weeks ago. I think it kind of got me on my wit's end. I was like, this is it. I can't be in my house anymore. I cannot be stuck in my house.
I
made my husband like shovel our driveway just enough so I could soak it out. So I was like, I can't. Like the rest of the world, you can be in your house and look at the snow. I've got to get out. Could not handle it. But Hebrews 13:5b says, for God has said, I will never fail you. I will never abandon you. Never. And Matthew 28:20 says, teach these new disciples to obey all the commands I have given you. And be sure of this, I am with you always, even to the end of the age.
God doesn't lose sight of you. And I think that's really, at the end of the day, please hear this. Like, God doesn't lose sight of you. You might feel like He can't see you because there's so much going on and you have all this pain and like, why is God leaving me alone? Like, He doesn't leave your side.
And I know like there's been seasons of my life where I've been really lonely and people will say those scriptures and I'll be like, that doesn't help because I don't see God. He's not tangible. He's not real, he is real, but he's not like,
but that's okay. Sometimes I think we
feel like he's in front of you, you know? And, but the truth is like, he never abandons us. He's always with us and we can see him all around us. It's just not in the way that we are, you know, our human brains like maybe are used to or expect. Like, no, we're not gonna see God like human form right in front of us. Like, that's probably not gonna be what we experience. However, like, God could send you a friend she has a point. God can send you a friend that, you know, can point you back to Him. Or maybe you go on a walk and you just, all the nature just reminds you, like, God is with you. And so those scriptures really are, like, they are true. God, He is never, never abandoned you. Like, He's never left you. He is with you.
Right. And one of the things, like the gratitude journal that we have, is something that I had to use this morning when I believed the lie. Like, this is really super recent. This morning I just felt alone, and I feel like God's told me to paint more, but I'm like, oh my gosh, that means I have to paint alone. Like, alone. I'm going to be alone forever. And whatever you're alone could look different right now. It could feel really isolating where really you feel like you don't have people. And I remember there was a season in my life where I was separating from some toxic relationships, and I was like actually alone for a while, and it really hurt. But even in that time, when I listed down the things I was worried about and the things that felt dark and the things that felt alone, and then I remembered in the other column, right next to each lie that I was believing that I was all alone, I wrote down like times that God had been faithful and provided in the past. And it really, really helped me remember that I'm not alone.
Right, and you can get this on Amazon, or you can go to landofroses.com. /shop, and it is in our shop as well. And so it's a great, I use this all the time, this method all the time.
Need it, yeah.
And so what lies are you believing? Write them down, and next to each one, write the truth of what God says. We actually are gonna be coming out with a journal really soon called the God Doesn't Say That Journal, where you can purchase that journal, and every time you believe a lie, the journal will help you with this method of just replacing that lie with God's truth. So if you need help finding a truth to combat a lie you're believing, check out our app where you can look up every emotion or season of life. And there's verses for every emotion and season of life in the app. And that scripture will remind you what's true, which is you're never alone. God is always with you. It's a good thing I have a loud voice.
That's right. So then remember that through God, or through faith in Jesus, we really can replace those lies. And it really comes back to being at the heart of the Father. He has good things for you. So no matter what you're going through this week, remember, if you're believing a lie, you can tell yourself, that's a lie. God doesn't say that. What's the truth? Mm-hmm. And if you want to know more about having a relationship with God so that you can learn more about what we're even talking about, go to landofroses.com/faith to start a relationship with God today. Mm-hmm. And remember, this is Katie and Rebecca helping you remember who God says you are.
Be encouraged to overcome the lies of the world this week. Hey everyone, thank you so much for watching that video. If you haven't yet, go ahead and hit the subscribe button so you can continue to explore faith with Lane of Roses all week. And go ahead and check out our next video right over there.